Hello friends, welcome to our today's video on Spark. In our today's video, we are going to learn what is a broadcast variable in Spark and how we are going to optimize the Spark code using the broadcast variable. So the use case that we are going to take today is, we are having a file in which we have few columns this data is related to the population data of US. So we have a city and a state code in which we have a code for each state, and we have a lookup file in which we have a appropriate state name for each state code. What we are going to do is, we are going to broadcast this lookup file and as a variable, and we are going to use this broadcasted variable to map and create a column called state, which will says like, for the state code, this is the state. This is the use case that we are going to deal with today. And this is the data set that we have today. We have around 150 records in our use case. And before moving on to our demo, let us see what the broadcast is. Let us see, if we haven't broadcasted, what happens is, that the variable will be available in the driver, and the task that requires that variable will directly will come to the driver and fetch it, and this involves the network traffic, and also it involves serialization and deserialization at driver's end, and again the serialization and deserialization at the task as the worker end. So this will increase the time, and it will degrade the performance or the efficiency of the Spark application. So now moving on to our broadcast approach, we will broadcast the variable, and this variable from the driver, it will be moved and broadcasted into every worker node, and it will be available in each and every worker node's memory. This will also be cached, so there will not be necessary for a serialization and deserialization. If any task requires the variable, then instead of looking for the driver, it will directly look into the worker node's memory and it will use it. By this way, we will reduce the network traffic, as well as since it is cached, we don't need a serialization and deserialization, which will improve the performance and optimizes the Spark code that we have developed. This is the overall view of what the broadcast is. Now let us quickly move on to our demo. Let us start with the PySpark. We are using Databricks Community Edition for our demo purpose. I had uploaded the file that we have into the file storage and ran it, as well as I have also created a dict which contains a key value pair of state code and then the state name. So I have executed that as well. Let us check what is the content that is available inside our I will give top 5 row alone, since we have around 150 and 160 rows. I will give top 5 alone. So now we have a dict which we are going to broadcast. For broadcasting, what the syntax is sc dot broadcast, and the variable that we need to broadcast, I am assigning it to the variable called say broad, and now the variable is ready. We can use this variable by giving a value method, value of, say for example, if I need it for New York, I'm giving a code as NY, it will return New York. This is the way by which we can get the value for the key that we are giving, and we can also see like broad has destroy and unpersist, which we need to look. Destroy is nothing but deleting the deleting the broadcast variable that is being stored in all the memory of executors, and unpersist is removing them from the cache memory. And if we use unpersist and use the logic for the brood, then it will again cache it. But if we use the destroy, then we will not be able to proceed further with the broadcast variable. It will completely remove it from the executor memory. So now let us define our function. For that I have to import the package. Let me import the package. So we have imported the packages. Now let us define our function. Let our function name be def of broadval, which takes the input as call name, and it will return this, where inside New York we have to give it as call. So we have declared a function. Let us register this as a UDF. For that we have to give pankraj is equal to UDF of broadval. So now we have registered this as a UDF. Let us check this with our broadcast column. I am giving the column name as state, and our logic will be pankraj, and the column name will be state underscore code. Let me give show directly. Might pull n number of records. So we can see our logic got work, and from the state code it is able to map a state for each and every code that we have. By this way we can use the broadcast variable. Since we are running it in a one node, the driver and a worker is acting as the same node. That's why we are unable to see the difference. If we are running in a multi-node cluster, then we can observe the difference of performance. And if we give broad unpersist and run the above command, I mean, like if I use the broadcast, it will till give the result. But if I give destroy means it will completely remove from the memory. If I am using it, it will throw the error stating the task is not serializable. So this is for PySpark. Now let us check for our Scala as well. I had opened a notebook for Scala. We can navigate through Python and Scala. Like from here, we can choose the default language as Scala or Python. I changed it from here only. Now I have executed the input, and also here we have using map type to define our functions. I mean to define our dictionary. And now let us create a broadcast. It is same as in PySpark. We have to give broadcast and the variable name. So it gets broadcasted. You can see it is getting broadcasted. And let us quickly define a function. For that we have to say like val func udf equal to udf of, and the function is, the input will be of type string and the output will be broad dot val value of our string. So this will be the UDF. So we have defined our UDF as well. So now let us give with column, and column name will be state, and the logic will be func UDF, and the column name will be state code. Let me give directly show command so that we will see the result. We can see the same logic we have applied, and we are able to map the state code to directly to the state name using Scala as well. Let us try unpersisting it. Got unpersisted. So let us try running the logic again. Even if we unpersist, the logic looks fine and it works. Now let us try destroying the broadcast variable. We destroyed it. Now let us try running the logic. Obviously it will throw the error stating the task is not serializable. So hope you understood the concept of broadcast variable and how it is being used, and what is the use of using the broadcast variable to optimize the Spark application. And please try this on your own machine. I will place the sample data file in the Git repository, and I will give the link in the description. Any problems, please let me know. I am happy to help you. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe to my channel and also share it with your friends if you really like my content. Thanks for watching.